ప్రణో దేవీ సరస్వతీ వాజేభిర్వాజినీవతీ ధీనామవిత్రియవతు ఆనో దివో బృహతః పర్వతాదా సరస్వతీ యజతాగంతు యజ్ఞం వాగ్దేవ్యై నమః. సుప్రభాతం. Yoga is practiced to attain the peace. In essence, that is the meaning of practicing yoga. Patanjali defines yoga chitta vritti nirodha. All of us very well familiar with this statement. The statement says whatever the modifications are the different vikara of the manas, once if he is able to overcome these chitta vikara or the different modifications, one will be established in the yoga sthiti. And once he establishes, what will be the result? It is prasada or the shanti. This is what in essence the practice of yoga gives the result. In one of the Jnana Yoga verses of Bhagavad Gita, beautifully it is portrayed, a person who practices yoga, he attains the peace. How? Prasade sarva dukkhanam hanirasyopajayate ప్రసన్న చేతసో హ్యాషు బుద్ధి పర్యవతిష్ఠతే. దిస్ ఇస్ ద వర్స్ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ బ్రాట్ అవుట్ ఇన్ ది సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ ఆఫ్ గీత. ప్రసాదే సర్వ దుఃఖానాం, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ హ్యావ్ అండర్గోయింగ్ బోత్ పెయిన్ అండ్ ద ప్లెషర్స్. నో వన్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ ఇన్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ ప్లెషర్ ఆర్ ద జాయ్ఫుల్నెస్ and also at the same time even miseries. It is a chain, it is one after the other, it will keep repeating. So a person who wanted to overcome all the miseries or the dukkha or the pains, how it is possible? Krishna says prasade sarva dukkhanam. Until and unless he attains the peaceful state of the mind, that shanti or the absolute establishing in the state of yoga is not possible. That's why one must try to establish in the prasada or the peaceful state of the tranquil state of the mind. Then a person who overcomes sarva dukkhanam, whatever may be the miseries, he can overcome very easily. ప్రసాదే సర్వదుఃఖానాం హాని అస్య ఉపజాయతే. వెరీ వెల్ అండర్స్టూడ్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్ అండ్ హీ ఓవర్కమ్స్ ది దుఃఖ ఆర్ ద మిజరీస్. ప్రసన్న చేతసో హి ఆశు బుద్ధి పర్యవతిష్టతే. హిస్ బుద్ధి విల్ బీ విత్డ్రాయింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్ ద డైరెక్షన్స్ అండ్ హీ ఎస్టాబ్లిషస్ ఇన్ ది యోగ అవస్థ. His intellect must be withdrawn from all the materialistic aspects. This is the way the yoga gives the result. But we have to elaborate for more understanding and the clarity. If you look at the Buddha's philosophy also, he has beautifully brought out four terminologies. They are named as four noble truths. He says the entire life journey can be classified under four noble truths. What are those? Dukkha, Samudaya, Magga, Nirodha. These are the Pali words, Pali language words. Dukkha, the moment we get birth until we die, we have to undergo miseries. This is the truth of this life. So dukkha is mandatory for all the living beings. in some or the other way. Second aspect is samudaya. For this dukkha or these pains or the miseries, there are some causes. Without cause, without root cause, there will be no sufferings. That's why it is samudaya. It is the number of root causes are responsible for the pain. And also magga. Okay, we have problems and we have root causes for the problems. Then what is the way out? That's what he says, magga. There is a path. There is no doubt there is path to practice and to overcome all these miseries. That is magga. And also the nirodha, the state where he overcomes all the miseries or the dukkha or the root causes for the dukkha. Then he attains the nirodha avastha. That's what also Patanjali says, yogaha chitta vritti nirodha. This is the way philosophically we can understand all master's message. It is one and the same. Words may be different, terminologies may be different, their way of practicing may be different, but the result is one and the same. That's why we have to analyze then what are the root causes for the dukkha. As we know very well, the desires. The moment we have desires, unwanted desires or wanted desires, these desires will lead you to the miseries. Why? Because all the desires cannot be fulfilled. It is not possible to completely fulfill our the desires, whatever we wish. That's why Krishna very beautifully says, kama krodhodbhavam vegam. The kama and the krodha as well as the vega, one must understand in the light of Gita. He says, shaknoti haiva yassodum praksharira vimokshanath kama krodhodbhavam vegam sa yuktaha sa sukhi naraha. Who is sukhi in the world? Who is happiest person in the world? What are the different ways he will be attaining that sukha or the happiness? Who is sukhi means, it says, praksharira vimokshanath. Before he leaves the body, before he attains the death in this mortal body, okay, he has to have the power of endurance. Endurance, the long sustaining steadiness of the mind. What are the state? Kama, krodha and vega. He has to keep analyzing again and again, again and again, what are the desires I have. And these desires, the result outcome is, because when the desires are not fulfilled, the result will be anger, krodha. And whenever you undergo krodha or the anger, we have to again analyze what are the root causes for this anger, krodha. And if your mind is so unsteady and speed, you have to again analyze what are the causes for my speedness of the mind, vega. In the modern understanding, the stress is defined as speed. Stress is speed. Means whenever the thoughts comes to the mind as a desires, and if they are not fulfilled completely, it creates an anxiety, and from anxiety it goes to the state of anger, and from anger it takes the speed. The mind takes the speed, that is nothing but stress, and followed by the stress, we know number of diseases are reflected in the physical body. Who is sukhi here? A yogi, a practitioner, or a sadhaka who can analyze all these three, kama, krodha, as well as the vega, and who can have absolute patience in all these three without any response. When the mind is speed, no response, let it be speed. When you are anger, don't respond. Or analyze what are the root causes. Then the desires you analyze. If a person understands these three and have control over these three aspects, sa yuktaha, sa sukhi, sa naraha, he is a perfect human being. Not all of us are human beings in a right manner. Who is the real man who establishes in the sukha or the happiness means sa sukhi. Whoever enjoys, rejoices that sukha by having control over the kama, krodha as well as the vega. So somewhere we have to minimize the speed of the mind. We have to slow down the mind. We have to slow down the breath. We have to slow down our running process. We are running, 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 running. Where we are going to reach, we don't know. So stop. Stop. Stand still somewhere and analyze. So this is the way a yogi analyzes the things. There was a person moving from dawn to dusk, continuously moving, moving, moving. His attention or his aim was to find out where is the exact coincidence of the north as well as the east. Where the exact point starts from north to the south. I want to meet that point specially. He was keep on running, 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 moving, 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 moving. This is a story comes in his Buddha's history, and he come across where Buddha was sitting, and he asked, I am continuously moving, moving, but I am unable to find out that meeting point of the south as well as the north. Can you please guide me? Then Buddha says, you stop here. I will guide you. No, no, how it is possible if I stop, how can I get it that meeting point? It is very difficult. So I have to move. You please tell me where that exact point I can meet. And Buddha says, until and unless you run, until and unless you keep moving, you can't meet that point. So you just stand still, sit down and go in, go within. And understand that wherever you are standing or wherever you are sitting still, that is the end point of the your north. From you, the south starts. So we are the end point, but we are keep on trying to find out the end point. We are keep on trying to find out the sukha, where it is available, running, running, running. Buddha says, don't do anything, just sit still. So whenever you sit still, everything calms down. The mind becomes absolutely free from all the speeds. The moment you sit, it is understood and realized experientially. So this is the way everything is in within us. The moment you go behind the objects, that cannot be attained. Even in fact in the life history of the Buddha also, the same incident we come across. The moment he left the home, he started as a monk all over the world, in country, different forest regions, different yoga masters, moving, moving, moving. What are the different methods to practice? He listened to all the yoga masters. He started practicing, and he never stopped. Like our all yoga student does, how they do? Even though they undergo some of the yoga practices from the particular specific yogic school, they are not satisfied. They wanted to explore all kind of yoga practices, all kind of yogic styles. That means nowhere they are established, continuously moving, moving, moving. They want every kind of yoga, dynamic yoga, power yoga, Iyengar yoga, Satyananda yoga, Shivananda yoga, every kind of yoga they want. But at last, nowhere they established in the yoga. This is the way all are moving, moving. So until and unless you stop somewhere, stand still, not possible. Buddha started roaming, roaming, roaming with all the instructions of the master. One fine day is completely exhausted. Completely exhausted, he thought that better to stop searching. He crossed the river called Niranjana, where there is no anjana, there are no kalmasha or the impurities. and sat under the tree. The next morning, he was an illuminated soul, Buddha. The moment you sit, the moment you are still, everything reveals. So this is the way a yogi analyzes the desires, kama, krodha, vega. You stop, everything is possible to feel and experience. So sa yuktaha, sa sukhi, sa naraha. He is told as a perfect human being where he has established in the happiness. Then what is the point here? Only thing, we have to somewhere stand and still. As we have understood the mechanism of all the different diseases, stress is the root cause. So somewhere you stop every day. Every day at least you sit somewhere, sit in your home or room. Don't do anything, just be still. Don't practice anything, again the mind becomes so speed. The moment you adopt some technique, okay? Technique, then again mind goes behind it. So your effort must be absolutely neutralized. You are practicing some technique as a dharana. Slowly you neutralize that effort too. That's what Patanjali says, prayatna shaithilya. You are practicing asanas, somewhere you stand still. You neutralize. And once you adopt any posture, be still. Relax your effort. Ananta samapatti bhyam. You can attain the samadhi very easily. So even asanas, or the pranayama, or the japa, or your contemplation on your own thoughts, you get that state and where you enjoy the absolute happiness. This is the way. Prasade sarva dukkha naam hanihi asya upajayate. And this prasada, peaceful state of the mind, will give you the absolute happiness, and also it removes, eliminates, evacuate all the miseries. Sarva dukkha naam. Prasannaha chetasohi ashuhu buddhi. His buddhi, his intellectual discrimination, removing from the concentration, from the objects, his buddhi establishes in absolute happiness. This is the way. Even a sutra or even one verse of our scriptures can guide you in a better manner to what we are achieving, what we are aiming for. So this is the way we have to understand in a practical manner each and everything, and at the same time practice. Until and unless the practice, this is not achievable. Atha yoga anushasanam. Yoga is a anushasana. It should be practiced. It is not something listening, writing and getting the certificate. No, it is just at last it is a practice. That's why wherever we are, wherever we go, sit for 5-10 minutes every day. Be still. No need to do anything. Don't follow any technique. Just be still. That is the way you can get the happiness. Thank you very much. Let us